In this tutorial, we'll show you how to load and calculate incremental workforce planning data using data management. So let's say you've recently loaded an entire data set into your workforce planning application. And now you need to import new records and update some existing records. You'll need to run calculations on the new and updated records. In data management, you can use the incremental file adapter to compare a source data file with a prior version of that file, identify new or changed records, and then load only those records. You can then set your data load rule to run a workforce rule that calculates the new and updated data. Enterprise Planning Cloud provides these workforce rules. If you are loading the default assignments such as additional earnings, benefits and taxes, or changing employee salary data, employee properties, or job properties, use the OWP incremental process data with synchronized definition workforce rule. If you are loading employee salary data, employee properties, or job properties and plan to calculate compensation using default assignments, use the OWP incremental process data with synchronized defaults workforce rule. The deciding which workforce rules to add section in the administering planning for Oracle Enterprise Planning and Budgeting Cloud documentation provides more information in these workforce rules. Here are the contents of my initial data file. It includes a header row which lists the dimensions you're loading. This is used when mapping dimensions. You can find source data file guidelines in the Preparing the Source Data File section of the Administering Planning for Oracle Enterprise Planning and Budgeting Cloud documentation. I'll be loading updated salary data for these employees. Let's go to Data Management. I'll register a data source that uses the incremental file adapter and associate my initial data file. Always save before proceeding to the next task. The data source is named after the file name. Next, let's take a look at my target application. My target application was registered when my application was created. You add your workforce rules on the Business Rules tab. After defining your data load rule, you associate it with a workforce rule so that it processes and calculates the most recently loaded data. I'll come back to this task after I create my data load rule. When you define import formats, you map dimensions to specify how source dimensions or columns map to the dimensions columns in the target application. For source, I'll select the data source I registered. For file type, I'll select the limited for all data types. The target is set to my application. After the initial save, I'll map source and target dimensions. Then, save again. You define locations to specify where to load data in the target system. The location links the import format to the target system. Make sure to have period and category mappings defined. Before adding any data load mappings, verify that you selected the correct location POV. You map members to identify how source dimensionality translates to target dimensionality based on source values during the data load. Data load mappings define relationships between source members and target dimension members within a single dimension. With mappings in place, I can create my data load rule. Again, verify that you selected the correct location POV. I'll enter a name for my data load rule, accept the default category selected, set the target plan type to my workforce cube, and select my import format. I'll save my data load rule and go to target options to verify that the load method is set to all data types with security and purge data file is set to no. By setting this option, I can download and view a data file that contains the data records that were imported or exported using my data load rule. For custom options, I'll leave all entry fields blank. I'll return to source filters and select my initial data file. Make sure to save your changes. Now that I have my data load rule created, I'll go back to my target application and associate my workforce rule and my data load rule. I'll be using the OWP incremental process data with synchronized definition workforce rule. After saving, I'll run my data load rule. Note the last process ID. Import from source takes the data from the source file and stages it in the workbench. Export to target exports the data to the target application. Verify the start and end periods. Selecting Replace as the import mode clears all the data for the POV in the workbench. Selecting store data as the export mode inserts the value from the source into the target application, replacing any existing data. After making your selections, run the data load rule. The last process ID is updated. Click Refresh to see the updated state of the data load. The status displays a green check mark when successful. You can also view data load results in the workbench. The status icons display as orange when the process was successful. I'll open my form to verify the data load. Data loaded successfully. Next, I'll run the rule using a data file that contains modified data. In Data Management, I'll upload a new source file for my data load rule. I'll save my changes, then run the data load rule. The run status displays a green check mark. Notice that the last process ID has changed. Because I set the purge data file option to no, I can download and view a data file that contains the data records that were imported or exported using my data load rule. I'll download the data file that matches the last process ID. The data file contains only the modified records, which were loaded into my application. The workbench shows which records were imported to the staging table. I'll open the form to verify. Here are the updated records. In this tutorial, you saw how to load and calculate incremental workforce planning data using data management. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.